Trying something a little different today. This is generic lager from Little Brown Jug Brewing in Winnipeg. There's no tasting notes on the can or anything else. They just describe it as impressively standard, which I'm wondering if that is a reference to standard lager, which was a Manitoba beer since, I think, the 1940s, but the big mega brewery who brewed it discontinued it last year. So, yeah, I'm wondering if that is a reference to that. Judging by the taste, I think it might just be a reference. Anyway, today I am going to be taking a look at this little smart Bluetooth outlet that I got from, you guessed it, Dollarama. Claims to work with all the usual suspects of spying on you, IoT. So that's cool, I guess, for people that are interested in that. It has Bluetooth, which is more interesting. However, the last Sylvania Smart Plus device that I looked at, that light bulb, you needed to log into their server and create an account and everything else before you could use the Bluetooth on it. So I'm not holding out any hope that this is going to be any different. But you never know. You could be surprised. And who knows? It could even be hackable. Comes with a little manual here. Doesn't say too much other than the usual cautions. It's got a code to pair it if you're using one of these proprietary systems. Or you can just force it into powering mode. And this is actually pretty much the same text as came with that light bulb, so I'm guessing it's probably the same chip inside. On the front of it, there's just one female plug and a little hole there, which I'm guessing is an LED to tell you what its status is. And on the back, there's some very low contrast text, which is not all that informative. 49th week of 2021, maybe? FCC ID if we want to dig a little deeper into it. Oh yeah, and it claims to be able to handle 15 amps with a resistive load. That's probably the most useful bit of information on the back of it. So I am going to guess that there is a relay and a little module in there. A module that is probably very similar to this one that I took out of that light bulb a few weeks back. We'll have to see. So there's an obvious seam around it. If I can get a spudger or two in there, I might be able to just get into it without completely and utterly destroying it. But it's kind of resisting my abuses here. Let's see if I can jam anything else into there. Non-destructive entry means doesn't seem to be doing anything. I may have to get destructive on this thing. These spudgers won't go down more than a millimeter or so. Right, violence ensues. Excuse me. There. Huh, that was a battle. Wow. So I didn't even notice this push button on the end here when I was initially looking at it, but it kind of got in the way of my grinding here. But wow, we are in. Woohoo! As expected, we have a relay. There's a little module. I'll get to that in a minute. That will be the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. There's the push button that is echoed through from the end of the case. There is the three prongs going to the load side. Oh, and this is interesting. See this little plastic doodad down in here? It's got a clicky push button under it. Listen, you can't hear that. So when you plug a load into it, that pushes down that little plastic guy and pushes the push button that's hiding underneath it, which I'm going to assume tells the microcontroller that there is in fact a load plugged in. That's kind of groovy. Where was that hole in the front of this thing? That's up in this corner here. Is there an LED underneath that? No, there is not. There's a diode and a resistor. Oh no, there's an LED just down below them. Okay. So that will faintly glow through that hole in the case, I guess, to indicate status. Right. What else have we got on here? Got some power supply action going on this side. We have a diode there. We have a bridge rectifier there. A couple of capacitors over here. That is marked L1, so that's an inductor. Another inductor here. And presumably a power supply chip, that little 8-pin guy there. KP3210S0.
KP3210SG, on second glance, that is actually what it is, not S0. It is a high-performance, low-cost, offline PWM power switch. Yep, it is a switch mode power supply chip. Okay, so there is the typical application circuit. It can be set up for either a greater than 10 volt or less than 10 volt output. Alrighty, so the bridge rectifier feeds a high voltage DC into there, a bit of smoothing, and depending on where this diode connects back into the feedback and current sense resistors will tell you, or I guess will determine whether it's a greater than or less than 10 volt output. Okay. Useful little chip by the sounds of it.
I guess that makes a certain amount of sense. That is a power supply chip. And as I said, we've got inductors and capacitors surrounding it. Then we've got this little guy here, marked U2, little 6-pin device. Actually a 5-pin device, marked 442A. I'm going to guess just because of where that is, that's also part of the power supply.
If my Googling is correct, it is a 300 milliamp low dropout regulator with reverse current protection. Looks like they're available in voltages from 2 volts to 15 volts. Okay. And if I'm reading this right, it is a 4.2 volt regulator.
I wonder if there's anything on the bottom side of this board other than just the AC input. No. That's interesting. The ground pin is just kind of jammed in there. I guess it doesn't need to make a contact to the internals. There is that little switch lever, and there is the switch that it pushes down on to tell the microcontroller that there's something plugged in. We have actually a little anti-tracking slots there and there, so that's kind of cool. Fuse there. So no components on the back of the board. There's the two anti-tracking slots we spotted from the other side. And there is another big one over here, which is in between the contacts of the relay. I guess that makes sense. And down at this end, where we started, we have a couple of transistors, diode up there, like we saw earlier, that LED, the push button to locally control it, and the relay, which claims to be able to handle 15 amps, 125 volts, which is in fact the rating that was written on the outside of the device. And then we have the little RF module / microcontroller, EWN8250, etc., etc. I don't recognize any of those numbers. Back to the Google machine.
Shockingly, I've been able to find a datasheet for every single thing in here. That's unheard of. So it is capable of Bluetooth LE, it has internal flash, it has audio support? Wow. 2.4 gigahertz IoT, yeah, Bluetooth 5 BLE. We have the 5.0 variant, so it's got 512K of flash in it. Can't imagine something that's doing this job would need more than that. And it also has 48K of on-chip SRAM. Cool. Yes, write protectable memory, so even if I knew how to get the memory out of this thing, I wouldn't be able to. Not that it matters. It runs on 3.3 volts, so maybe I misunderstood that regulator, or maybe there's something else happening to drop the voltage down for this guy. Not sure. So what else can we learn about this guy? It has 7 pins, so not a lot of GPIO. Power, ground, and 5 GPIO pins. All of them are capable of PWM. 2 of them are ADC inputs. I guess that guy is more than capable of handling just such a light load like this. Nifty little chip.
So it looks like out of those five GPIOs, it's using probably three of them. One for that push button, one for this push button here, one for the output to there. Well, just for fun, let's see if we can find some voltages in there just to figure out a little bit more about what's going on. So we can figure out if this guy is in fact a 3.3 volt regulator, which would make more sense. Since this thing wants 3.3 volts. Oh, that's not what I expected. Can you hear that? The relay is just clicking away here. Okay. So does this do anything? Doesn't make any change. Does this? No. Let's just measure across some of these little ceramic caps down here by the power supply. I'm assuming we should get whatever the output of that is. Half a volt. That's not good. There's 7 volts across that one. Okay. So presumably that's what this guy's putting out. Am I in a positive or minus here? Okay, so that's a negative side. Let's see if we can find any voltage over here. That's bouncing all over the place. That's bouncing all over the place. That's a capacitor associated with the regulator there. So I'm going to assume that probably that regulator's bad or something. Upon closer inspection, it looks like my ham-fisted spudge ring obliterated that component there. That would probably explain why the power supply is not working properly. Regardless, I wasn't planning on using this anyway, although I was thinking possibly if this module was big enough physically in there, I might try and replace it with an ESP01 module, but I don't think there's enough room in there for that. It is pretty tight inside there. It's a very, very thick casement. That's surprisingly thick. So that is, I guess, good for electrical insulation, but I don't think that leaves enough room for one of these guys in there, which is too bad, because that would have been a interesting little way to reverse engineer it, or not reverse engineer it, to modify it so that it's not spying on me or sending information home or forcing me to use its proprietary app. Anyway, I learned what I needed to learn about that. I hope that satisfied your curiosity a little bit too. If you see one of these things at your local discount store, I suppose I could salvage the relay and some components out of there. That's about the only value I think I can get out of it. Other than, of course, the value of curiosity and learning. Well, thanks for watching. Questions and comments down below as usual. I will talk to you later.